Hello, this is artist and printmaker Graham Pilling. I thought I would take some time to take you through the process of a piece of screen-printed artwork I recently created for an official Monty Python exhibition organised by the lovely people at Colour+Noun. I was really pleased to be asked to contribute to this exhibition because I'm a big Monty Python fan. Of all the Python creations, one of my favourite is Monty Python and the Holy Grail. So I knew straight away that I wanted to do a piece of artwork to do with that. And one of my favourite characters, which we see the dramatic introduction of here, is the Enchanter, played by the wonderful John Cleese. I love this scene. It's completely ridiculous and over the top, with pyrotechnics and the amazing wide-angle shot. It must have been really difficult for them to do, given the sort of constraints, budgetary and technical and so on, but it's sort of classic Python, really. This big, grandiose fanfare and build-up, followed by a deflating and rather silly payoff, so that when he's asked to introduce himself, we get the wonderful line of dialogue in response.
What manner of man are you that can summon up fire without flint or tinder?
I'm an enchanter.
By what name are you known?
There are some who call me Tim.
Greetings, Tim the Enchanter.
Greetings, King Arthur.
So this is my initial sketch. I liked the idea of creating a visual representation of that scene. So we've got the dramatic looking landscape, obviously Tim in a place of prominence there, but essentially it's just an over the top setup for the joke line of dialogue at the bottom. As I added the grail and the killer rabbit, I had the idea perhaps of printing the rabbit in a different place on each individual print to make them unique. I wasn't entirely sure how I was going to do that, but I liked the idea of it. So I sent my idea off for approval, and thankfully everyone involved liked it, so I began to work on the final artwork, which I built up as a digital painting, as you can see here. In terms of style, I wanted to reference the feel of some of those great 70s and 80s sci-fi and fantasy paintings, so there's definitely a little Roger Dean in there, perhaps a little Mobius. I also wanted the elements of the illustration to look somewhat as though they're cut out of paper and perhaps could be animated, particularly the clouds, so this of course is a direct nod to the fantastic work of Terry Gilliam himself. I then had to separate the artwork down into the specific colours that I would be hand printing. Most of my screen printed work is no more than usually three or four colours, but I quickly realised this would be at least six. For me, this would end up being the most ambitious print I've attempted, but I liked the idea that it fit conceptually with the format of the joke, basically. Tim's dramatic and over-the-top entrance being mirrored by the actual physical printing process being a bit more labour-intensive and a little bit more over-the-top than I would usually go for, at least for my printing ability. The main image ended up being seven colours, eight if we count the printing of the rabbit. Now onto the printing process. If you're not familiar with screen printing, you basically create a stencil for each colour on a screen using spam and a coconut husk. Here are some photos from the printing process. It's quite labour-intensive, but there are quite a few things that I'm paying attention to and adjusting as I go through, just making sure that everything is printing nicely and is registered nicely. Here is some exciting time-lapse footage of me printing the penultimate screen. final bit of printing was the tiny killer rabbit. I created a screen with four different rabbit poses, and for each individual print, I simply chose a rabbit, lined it up in a place on the image, and printed it in white ink with a very small squeegee. There are 50 prints in the edition, and the rabbit is in a different place on every single print. The rabbit's eye, incidentally, I added with a fine red pen when I signed and numbered the prints. After the prints were trimmed to size, I went through and quality checked them, discarding any prints that for whatever reason weren't quite right, and then the final edition of 50 were signed and numbered. I'm pleased with how this came out in the end. It's worth me noting though that I don't consider this print to be flawless, even though my registration was quite precise. Certain parts of the image actually expand during the process as the ink dries on the paper, and there are some areas where things don't line up absolutely perfectly. The colours also sometimes dry a little bit different, and they actually ended up being slightly more vibrant on the final print as compared with the digital artwork, and little things like the sky, as that was a blend of dark into light ink. There are certainly variations throughout the edition of how smooth that blend is. But it's a hand-printed piece of art, and at least for me personally, I quite like to see those tiny imperfections in the final print, as I think it adds to the charm and uniqueness of the process. So that's the final print, limited to 50, never to be reprinted, and available from the Colour+Noun website for a very affordable price. Thank you for listening to my boring voice. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm off now to cut down the tallest tree in the forest with a herring. Goodbye!